But there's Jamie landing safely on the downside. Here comes Cambridge. Landing probably a little short there, but every jump, the first jump, is always the most nervous one. Here's Jamie then, 5 times British champion from Exeter. 31 years of age, full-time rider, the owner and rider of Swift Freestyle. We've got there Chris then. Would be your British riders. That would be good if it wasn't the Olympics though, wouldn't it? Really it's down to you to give them a bit of courage. Get them warmed up. Got Jamie that here is actually riding at the Formula One, keeping the seatbelts.
When you see the foxhounds coming in riding their lovely horses and you realise that a horse is dangerous both ends and in fact coming in now, come on mum!
Right, in a minute what we'll do is we'll move the children down to one side so the hounds have a little bit of space. Come on down this way children. She's going to run as well, I don't know. What's your running like, Martin? What's your running like?
Are you chief whipping?
Right, all the children on this end. Come away from the hounds now.
When you come down the station room now, or after you go and get my assistant, and you'll be in even more trouble. I'm going to get your sister. I didn't say no sister, I said my assistant. Now where am I?
The lights are on, the fans are on. They've got sulfur in the water, which is good for the blood, I believe, on a hot day. Anybody who wants a drink for your dog, they'll come and see us. We've got plenty of water down there. And if you don't pass it out, we're next to the vet. So we're all nice and safe. Don't do them too many because it's hot. I'll get tired. Where that young lady down there, the young man with those ice cream, she has, you come in with your dogs.
Tramp or a beekeeper?
Thank you. coming inside, I've got those little spots. Yes.
Points in the sheep classes, and this was won by Lord Clinton with his Taxo, scoring 21 points. Reserve was Nick Barrington with the Full Dorset with 18 points.
Ladies and gentlemen, you must congratulate all these competitors. Hot weather, animals really can suffer in this weather.
Very, very well done. John, let's watch the
rice spinners. They certainly deserve it. And the more humane, it is awfully hot for them, I do appreciate that. Let me come on to the presentation of the Huntington District Long Service Employee Award.
That's a big boy, isn't it?
So could we have the long service awards people please to peer into the ring? We're looking for Mr. Lawrence Cure, Raymond Hall. In you come, sir. Hey. Lawrence Cure, Raymond Horn, Jesse Fisher, and Robert White, if you're about, would you please come in for the presentation? Because for 52 years he's been employed by our Callaway of Coffee Farm Clay Hard. 52 years on one farm, on a magnificent feat. And not far behind him, in second place, with 46 years service employed by Emma Barra from Gateshead Farm Whipple, Raymond Horn. Jeffrey Fisher, for 36 years employed by Collier Brothers in the Long Region, and Robert White, with B.G. Hayman in son here at Gillingham Honiton, and he was in fourth position. Gentlemen, that concludes the presentations for 2013 here at Honiton. And shortly, once the trade is left, we will be coming on to the next part of the entertainment.
I'm taking first place.
with you the teams in just a moment. Versus team, which one can draw first, ladies? They have the heats a little earlier in the day on the other club. Those will be 14 through to the finals.
The Young Farmers Tug of War.
The Young Farmers who are in the corner with a good piece come to the main ring. The ladies, Home Valley ladies versus Wimbledon and Broadway.
Yeah, because they live in
London.
Was it more
valuable? Right, good afternoon. We've called the pre-round a little bit further up in the field, and you would have seen that, I'm sure, if you're in that area where the animals are. We've all just come back down, and the top two teams, the men's competition and the ladies' competition, are just going to call their final call. We're going to do the ladies first, and I think we may have got everyone here. Just give her a couple of minutes. She was sorting out the cattle before she came back to the tug of war. The ladies in blue are Colne Valley. The ladies in scarlet are Wimbledon Broadcliffs. I think they're pulling seven aside instead of eight aside, due to injury colour or whatever. But normally we call it eight. This is a catch weight competition for both the men and the ladies, which means it's as heavy as they can make it. We do other weighted competitions where, say, the whole weight of the team can't be more than 640 kilos, 4 kilos, I'm afraid. 680 kilos or 600. So this is a catch weight, as heavy as they like. They've all got a little bit of technique. They've all been doing it a little while. And I think we're there. Are we ready? Okay, so can we see Colne Valley ladies and Wimbledon Broadcliffs ladies on the rope then, please? And the judge this afternoon is Nick from Ashburton, Tug of War Association judge.
Sorry about Winnie Jane, but there's an urgent message, please, to Margaret Wilson. Please go to the orange gate. Margaret Wilson, please go to the orange gate. To meet Mary Smallwood. So Margaret Wilson to the orange gate, please. Mary Smallwood is there. Thank you.
Okay, so ladies will just face themselves out. If you've not seen Tug of War before, I'm sure most of you will have, because it's a young farmer's thing. It starts right at ground level with young farmers in this country. You'll notice a lot of them, if not all, but most have switched to wearing ski boots. Used to wear the old leather boots, the old army boots, and put metal plates on. Judge checks the plates on the boots because there are things that are allowed and there are things that are not allowed, like spikes when you're running. It's all very controlled. So that's what he's checking now. They're not praying. This one we don't have to check the weights of the team because, as I said to you earlier on, it's a catch weight competition, as heavy as they like.
Oh, right.
But if it were a weighted competition, then they would stamp it on their leg or on their arm, the weight category they were in, and we'd check that as well. So normally eight aside, today seven aside. We need really a coach for the Wimple and Broadcliffe girls. Andy?
I don't know if he's
not listening to me. Andy.
I
Would you come? It always helps if you've got a coach.
His girlfriend does.
Colne Valley has got a coach. So we'll get one of the Colne Valley boys who's sporting going to coach the beautiful girls. They know each other, obviously. So they're on the OTC books. It helps give them support actually when they're probably, they look a bit ungainly to walk in. Obviously that's not what they're meant for. But most of the teams countrywide are using them. So give them a bit of encouragement in this hot weather. The blues are Colne Valley. The reds are Wimpole and Broadcliffe. I just won't let them stay on the ground too long. It is fresh ground, don't forget. So it's going to be a bit slidy. They haven't dug up the ground like they would in a normal competition or on the same day. So, best then for the Colne Valley girls. Now, Colne Valley this weekend, both the Colne Valley ladies team you see here, and I think some of the other teams will mix in and make up the numbers for them. They're going forward with the Colne Valley men's team you'll see later. I think this is fairly level ground. Slides away a little bit this side, but it's all done on the toss of the coin anyway. If we have to pull a third end, then we'll toss the coin and they'll win a choose the end, obviously.
I like it
when it's kept like that. Oh, looks like we've got a coach to ride late.
Small idea, huh?
Yeah, so. Now you'll notice sometimes, Ken's off, never mind, Ken. You'll notice they're putting something on their hands, and it's a redding type based thing which helps grip the rope and also really protect your hands from rope burns. So you'll notice the teams do use that. We call it tacky, but it is resin and petrol mix.
We weren't supposed to, but I snuck in.
It's not the sort of thing you want to cook in your kitchen on the stove, put it that way.
It's not very good, but I've done it on the rope.
Now technique is a lot of this. Obviously with novice teams, weight can make all the difference. But when you've got a little bit of knowledge, a team could easily beat a novice team even if they weigh nowhere near the same total weight for the team. So technique is the thing. As I did explain to you, it's hard to get your Colne Valley ladies again. It's hard to get purchased.
Honiton men's in the blue versus Colne Valley in the black.
In the afternoon, go to turn forward and look for the tug of war signs. Okay, I think we're ready, so if we come to teams on then please. Colne Valley in the black and the local Honiton side in the green. Now you'll notice we've got one Colne Valley colour pulling with Honiton. Not unheard of, we do share team members, I'm sure. We're quite a convivial sporting sport. And so follow them all you like. No, we aren't got a. We're just walking out in wrong order. We have got 8 men from Honiton and we have got 8 men from Colne Valley, but they can swap colours if they're short. Somebody will weigh in for that team to help out. Not unheard of.
Why do they have to wear?
Now, the Honiton men are favouring the traditional leather boots. I don't think it really makes too much difference, but as I said, the teams are going the other way. They're the team games, which is held in Colombia. And one of our teams from Stafford, called Norton, very strong and well turned out team. They came second to Switzerland. It was a really hard call, but they really are the top of the teams that we have in this country, Norton. A couple of other teams went over from Bristol, I know. They came fifth out of their group, but it is a worldwide sport. We are accepted again into the Olympic arena. You have to have 75 participating countries to do it. So we're hoping we'll soon get on the Olympic agenda again, but they have to throw other sports out to do that, so I'm not quite sure when we'll be on the itinerary. Okay, so they do need a bit of encouragement. It's Honiton, your local side in green. That's more like it. It was last week's Colne Valley boys, and they're not too far away. They'll be doing a